execution means there are many transactions are executing in the same system without disturbing each other. Then what are the advantages of executing this transaction concurrently? What are the different benefits of executing the transaction concurrently? The first important benefit that it increases processor and disk utilization, leading to the better performance of transaction throughput. In short, we can say that the overall performance of the system gets enhanced, efficiency gets enhanced, right? If you execute the transaction concurrently, then definitely the time required to execute the transaction will be less. One transaction can be using the CPU time while another transaction is reading or writing to the disk. That is possible when you execute the transaction concurrently. So it means that there is 100% utilization of the CPU, and in turn, it will increase the transaction throughput, or it enhances the transaction throughput. That is the first advantage. Second is that there is reduced average response time for each transaction happening in the system concurrently. Why this time gets reduced? So listen, short transaction need not wait behind long transactions. In the system, if the transactions are executing concurrently, there may be some transaction which are very long, and there may be some transaction which are very short. And suppose if they are not executing in concurrent system, then what will happen? The shorter transaction have to wait for a longer time for their turn to get the CPU utilization for its execution. They need to wait. That would not happen into concurrent execution of transaction, because CPU switches from one transaction to another transaction within fraction of time. It looks like for a transaction that they are happening serially, but in the background the CPU switches from one transaction to another transaction within fraction of time, and because of that every transaction gets equal amount of time for its execution. That is CPU utilization time. And as a result, all the transactions complete within time and the throughput gets increased. But here in this case, when we execute a transaction concurrently, the shorter transaction need not have to wait for longer transaction to complete and then the turn come for a shorter transaction. Right. So that this is the second advantage of executing multiple transactions concurrently. When it happens, then there is always reduced response time for the transactions. Basically, we use this concurrent executions to improve the overall performance of the system. But it also lead to some problems. Whenever there is some advantage for a system, there is also a disadvantage. There may be some error, blind writes may happen into the database because of the concurrent execution of the transaction. For controlling this concurrent executions of the transaction, there must be some mechanism, and that mechanism is called as concurrency control scheme. They are basically used to achieve the isolation of all the concurrent execution of transaction. It means that because of the concurrency control scheme, we are able to control the different transactions that are happening into the system, and they should not mix each other, right? So that would be possible because of concurrency control scheme that we'll see later on. That is basically used, these concurrency control schemes are basically used to control the interaction among the concurrent transaction in order to prevent them from destroying the consistency of the database. It means that when they execute in isolation, they always preserve the consistency of the database. There is no problem with the consistency of the database if they are executed in isolation. But what happens if they mix each other? They are not exhibiting in isolation. Then they may lead your database into inconsistent state, inconsistent database. So how to prevent such type of blind writes or such type of errors or such type of problems? For that, we have concurrency control algorithms or concurrency control scheme that we are going to see later on into this module. Let us